What you're about to see here is my last build of 2018, which consists on an Skylake i5-6500 paired with 12GB of RAM and an EVGA GTX 960, and is capable of running macOS High Sierra, which I'll be using for video editing, as well as gaming on Windows 10. Now, for the motherboard, I pick a quite interesting one, the Gigabyte G8B150M DDR3. I know it's kinda odd to put together an Skylake processor with DDR3 RAM, but it will do the job just fine. For the CPU, I pick the Intel Core i5-6500, a really nice Skylake chip with 4 cores, 4 threads, with a base clock of 3.2 GHz with a turbo boost up to 3.6 GHz. For the RAM, I pick up the Corsair Vengeance Red Kit with 8GB of DDR3 RAM clocked at 1866MHz. And since I had a 4GB Bluetooth lying around, I decided to put it into the build. For the GPU, I decided to go with an NVIDIA GTX 960 2GB from the EVGA. This is a really good card for the money that is still capable of 4K editing without dropping much frames at complete resolution in Adobe Premiere Pro CC, as well as gaming at 1080p 60 frames plus with medium to high settings, and even being able to run some AAA releases at 1080p low to medium settings. Since I'm a huge fan of EVGA, for the power supply I pick an EVGA 600W 80+35, which would easily handle with efficiency all the components. For the storage, I'll be using the 240GB Kingston SSDs as my boot drives for Windows 10 and macOS High Sierra, and a 2TB hard disk drive to storage games as well as media. Last but not least, the case. I choose the IP case M52W Goldenfield Micro ATX, a cheap but really good looking case that also comes with a blue LED fan. I'll be installing Windows 10, and once it finishes the process, I will start with the Hackintosh installation. For the benchmark, I will start with the synthetic ones, both done in Windows and macOS. In Cinebench R15, we score 540 on macOS in CPU performance and 538 on Windows, which is about the same performance. On the GPU side, we got 84 frames on macOS and 94 frames on Windows. On Geekbench, we score 4689 in single core and 3138 in multi-core, showing us how good it performs even on a Hackintosh. And on the Windows side, we got a quite comparable difference. On macOS, with a basic preset at 720p, we scored 2,740 points, with performance giving us an average of 108 FPS, with a minimum of 14 FPS and a maximum of 201 FPS. On the other hand, on Windows, in Direct Night, I encountered a better load performance compared to macOS on OpenGL, scoring 2,231 points, with performance averaging 88.6 FPS, a minimum of 21.6 FPS, and a maximum of 188.9. Overall, it performed pretty bad. So at this point, to be fair and have a consistent result, I decided to switch to OpenGL on Windows with the same preset. Now Windows running it on OpenGL with the same preset, we scored 2020 points, with performance giving us an average of 120 FPS, a minimum of 12.4 FPS, and a maximum of 207 FPS, which is a huge improvement from the Direct 9 results on macOS ones. On macOS with the Ultra preset at 1080p, we scored 780 points, with a frame rate of 28.5 FPS, a minimum of 9 FPS, and a maximum of 63 FPS. And this is a pretty respectable performance considering the fact that the Ultra preset is set by default to be run at 900p. On Windows Ultra preset 1080p with the DX11 API, we scored 792 points with an average performance of 31.4 FPS, a minimum of 11.8 FPS, and a maximum of 67.6 FPS. Now for the gaming part, I'll be showing you the frame times as well as the MSI Afterburner plus Rivatoner statistics. As you can see, this is a pretty good gaming and video editing machine that also serves for live streaming. And for the money spent, there isn't much to complain about. I know a lot of you will be asking why I use DDR3 RAM instead of DDR4, and the reason why is because these bars were picked secondhand and tends to supply shortages and alleged price to RAM during most of the year. This seems like a cheap, reasonable option. And I kept this stock into CPU cooler because of the price to performance ratio we were looking for, it wasn't worth the hassle. And after a lot of benchmarking and real life testing, it was getting pretty good temperatures. I really hope you liked this video, don't forget to leave your comment down below, and if you want to see more content like this, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye for now.